Hello? This tutorial will teach you how to control the Mirobot with ROS. Please subscribe and leave comments so we can create more content that fits your needs. Now let's start.
The purpose of this experiment is to learn how to use ROS to control a real robot arm, that is Mirobot. In the previous experiment, you have practiced creating a ROS node in an Arduino board, setting it to subscribe a topic called joint state, and implementing a callback function to analyze the topic's messages and send them back to their report for printing. In this experiment, you need to replicate the function with another method without altering any firmware code in the Arduino board. This experiment is very simple. First, you need to install the theorylib by calling this command, the necessary library function we need when we get rid and write the data through the report. So I think just copy and paste it to my terminal. So install the library. Next, you need to compile the Mirobot write node with C code file. And you can find this file in the Mirobot GitHub repo. I already download and compile it in my environment, so I can show you where it is. So this ROS for Mirobot is the Mirobot GitHub repo. You can enter this folder and Mirobot UR2. SRC. You can should see this file here. So I already opened in the subint here. You can see that this is actually a very simple file. So this will it starts at a ROS node and subscribe this method called the joint state and the callback function. In this ankle write callback function is defined here. So basically, what it does is receive the message that is the six joint values sent by some other node and print them. And the change base values from reading to degree, and then generate this G code format, and then send this G code to the theory port. This theory port will be connected to your real Mirobot using the USB to theory converter port. So here, if it's the Mirobot write code. So next, you need to compile it. So to compile it, you need to go back to the ROS workspace root file and call gate function of catking make to compare all the messages in your workspace. Next, you need to connect your Mirobot with your computer using USB port. Then find out this stereo port in your system and change its permission to allow reading and writing. In my PC, after I connect the Mirobot to my PC, I can see where it is. PVPYUSB0. You can see that there's only one USB port, so that is the one that I'm looking for. So I can call this function to change this permission. Next, I can run this display launch file to control the robot through the joint state publisher. So this display launch is also in the Mirobot GitHub repo. So you can find out here under the Mirobot UIDF for directory and the subdirectory launch here. You can just ROS launch display file. But you can see this is the robot. I can change the joint value to move it virtually, and also your real Mirobot should be changed, should be to move in the same way as it is showing in this virtualization tool here.
That's it for our WLKATA ROS tutorial. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe. Don't forget to hit the notification bell, leave a comment to let us know your questions or what tutorial you want next, so we can keep bringing you content you'll love. Thanks for watching.